Hello everybody, I'm Dr. Poona Bose, Professor in HOD Physics, Govind VYT PG Autonomous College, Durg. Today I'm going to deliver one lecture on the topic collisionless Boltzmann equation, which is in the syllabus of MSc second semester physics, paper 3 and unit 4. So let me start with the collisionless Boltzmann equation. Collisionless Boltzmann equation, the differential kinetic equation satisfied by the distribution function, is known as Boltzmann equation. The dependence of distribution function on the independent variables R, V, and T is governed by this equation. In the present case, effect of collisions are incorporated into this kinetic equation only through a general unspecified collision term. So, collisionless Boltzmann equation. Now, we have explained above the number density, which is given by d raised to the power of 6 n alpha equal to f alpha r v t multiplied by d cube r d cube v. Let it be equation number 1. This number density represents the number of particles of type alpha that at the instant t are situated inside volume element d cube r d cube v of phase space about the coordinates r v. Suppose that each particle is subjected to an external force F in the absence of particle interaction. In the absence of force particle interactions, a particle of type alpha with coordinates about r v in phase space at the instant t will be found after a time interval dt about the new coordinates r dash v dash, such that r dash, which is a function of t plus dt, this is equal to r function of t plus v into dt. Let it be equation number 2. And v dash, which is function of t plus dt, is given by v function of t plus a into dt. Let it be equation number 3. When a equal to f divided by m alpha is the particle acceleration and m alpha is its mass, so all the particles of type alpha inside the volume element d cube r d cube v of phase space about r v at the instant t will occupy a new volume element d cube r dash d cube v dash about the point r dash v dash. This is shown by this figure. Now, the same particle at the instant, which is shown in the figure 4. Since we are containing the same particles at t and time t plus dt, we must have, in the absence of collisions, f alpha, which is function of r dash v dash t plus dt multiplied by d cube r dash d cube v dash, which is equal to f alpha function of r v and t d cube r d cube v. So let it be equation number 4. This is the value of r v d q bar d q v and the change value at the time t plus dt which is given by d q bar dash d q v dash. Now the y along y axis we have taken the position vector r, and along x axis we have taken the velocity vector v. Now the element of volume d cube r d cube v may become distorted in shape as a result of the particle motion. The relation between the new element of volume and the initial one is given by d cube r dash d cube v dash equal to absolute value of j d cube r d cube v. Let it be equation number 5, where capital J stands for the Jacobian of the transformation. From the initial coordinates r v to the final coordinate r dash v dash, the Jacobian, absolute value of Jacobian is equal to 1 is taken here. So we have d cube r dash d cube v dash equal to d cube r d cube v. This is given by equation number 6. Now equation 4 becomes, substituting this value, equation 4 becomes f alpha d cube r dash v dash t plus dt equal to minus f alpha function of r v and t multiplied by d cube r d cube v. This is equal to 0. Let it be equation number 7. The first term of the left hand side of equation 7 can be expanded in a Taylor series about f alpha function of r v and t as follows: f alpha function of r plus v t dash t v plus a dt and t plus dt. This is equal to f alpha r v t plus delta f alpha by delta t plus vx delta f alpha by delta x plus plus vy delta f alpha by delta y plus vz delta f alpha by delta z plus ax delta f alpha by delta vx plus ay delta f alpha by delta y delta vy plus az delta f alpha by delta vz whole multiplied by dt. Now neglecting the terms of the order dt square and higher terms, using the del operator notation as del equal to x cap delta by delta x plus y cap delta by delta y plus z cap delta by delta z. This is equation number 5. We obtain from equation 8 f alpha function of r plus vt v plus adt t plus dt equal to f alpha function of r vt plus delta by delta f alpha by delta t, which is function of r vt, plus v dot del f alpha function of r vt plus e multiplied by del with subscript v f alpha function of r vt. This is equal to 0, where del with subscript v, this is equal to x cap delta by delta vx plus y cap delta by delta vy plus z cap delta by delta z. Substituting the result of equation 10 in equation 7, we have delta f alpha function of f alpha function of r v t by delta t plus v dot del f alpha function of r v t plus a dot del with subscript v f alpha function of r v t equal to 0. Let it be equation number 12, which is Boltzmann equation in the absence of collisions. The equation can be rewritten as d capital D f alpha function of r v t by capital D by dt, capital dt, this is equal to 0. Let it be equation number 13, where the operator capital D by capital dt equal to delta by delta t plus v dot del plus a dot del with subscript v. We have neglected here. This is equation number 14. Represents the total derivative with respect to time in phase space. Now, equation 14 is a statement of conservation of density of representative points in phase space. Now, so this is all about Boltzmann equation. Now, there is a small another type of equation which is related with the equation. This equation is known as Liouville's. This is a theorem which is known as Liouville's theorem. Now, if we move along with a representative point f alpha function of r, v and t in its neighborhood, we find that this density remains constant in time. This result is known as Liouville's theorem. Note that this result applies only to the special case in which collision as well as radiation losses of production and loss of particles are unimportant. So this is all about Boltzmann's collisionless equation. I think you have liked my lecture. Now, thank you very much for listening to my video lecture. Thank you once again.